from faith to faith, as it is written, the just shall live by faith. Now notice this. Why does it say faith to faith? Because see, right here tells you therein in the power of Jesus, you're made right. So now comes faith therein to make you available to do more in God. In other words, faith starts somewhere, but now I move into another arena of faith. In my walk with Jesus. Jesus delivered me from this issue. Now I'm moving more in Jesus. And I'm moving more in Jesus. See, you never stagnate your faith. You never plateau your faith. You never rely on yesterday's faith. Now, I'm going to tell you, there's a lot of people rely on yesterday's faith. And that yesterday's faith is not good for you today. Come on, church. That house that we bought years ago, we're believing God for to go ahead and sell it and get another house. Why? Because, see, faith doesn't keep us. Well, all our children are gone. We don't need a four-bedroom now. I can't find Christine half the time. Where are you? In Jason's bedroom. Jason's been gone 4 years. Where are you? Teresa's bedroom. She's been gone. How long, Andrew? 6 years? 5 years? But we still got their names. Well, I'm in Jennifer's room. She's been gone 20-some years. I don't know. And so what's happening is faith is still working. Faith is still operating. Thank you, Lord, for that. We're going to look at the house. Well, amen. It's a beautiful house, but hey, we'll just see what God says about that house. We'll just see what's happening. Faith is still active. The same it is with every area of life. Start off with believing God for a healing through your in a headache instead of taking Tylenol, whatever you take.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
See, you have to begin somewhere.
That's right.
There was a man in church that had a problem with what do you call it? He was always, what's it called? He was always burping. What's the proper word of that? Amen. Well, that's another word too. Amen. He was always belching. Amen. I like that one better. Amen. Yeah. What was that called?
Acid
reflux in church. And he would sit front row. And he was an ex-Navy man, and he loved the Lord, but he just every time pastor preached, and pastor said, "My goodness, get faith, man." Amen. And so he was a great prison worker. So he was a chaplain for the prison ministry. And he came to my office one day. He said, "Pastor, you got to believe with me for healing. I'm just taking so much of this stuff, and I'm just so chalked up." He's taking all that stuff, you know, to get him calm. And I said, "Do you like this?" He says, "No." I said, "Well, why don't you just look at it and tell it you hate it?" So he did. He got those Tums and whatever it was, and he put it on my desk. He did it, and I didn't do it. He said, "I hate you in Jesus' name." I never heard that. He was so boisterous. He was a military guy. So he said it real loud. And I'm telling you, every time he birthed, he said, "I hate that in Jesus' name," and I'm healed in service. And one day, he was just totally healed. But this is what he said. He said, "It all started when I believed what you said. Do you hate those things?" He never got concept of that. You see where his faith was? First of all, I hate it. Faith operated there by saying that he hated it. Then faith increased in him. And by the time he was delivered and set free. Amen. So this is what he's saying. See, he's the righteousness of God. He's positioned to receive the power of God. He loves the Lord. He serves the Lord. He's right standing with God. But he just had a hard time being delivered over belching. Amen. And so we have to understand something. This is where the operation of where we're going in the things of God. God wants us to increase in faith.
Yes, he does.
There's people in this room that God has called you to do great things, but you're settling because you just don't know how further to go. But I'm telling you, you'll activate your faith belief in God, and I can have all things, all things, all things. Nothing will be impossible to you, those that believe. Amen. Come on. Tell me, nothing is impossible. Tell your neighbor, nothing is impossible. Amen. And see, we become faith giants. Hallelujah. Amen. We become faith giants. Can you say amen?